Good evening to one and all. I'm Rosetta here, and welcome to day 5 of the Navina events. Today we have the cooking competition event, and I'm so happy to tell you that we have received entries right from our little toddlers of 6 years old to our super cooks of 60 plus years. Each one of them showcasing their unique talents and cooking skills. But most of all, it is a time for us to celebrate and enjoy food. Even in the Bible, we see Jesus feeding 5,000 people, turning water into wine, so that everyone can come together and enjoy and celebrate. Food is a symbolic way for us to celebrate with each other and to show gratitude for whatever God has blessed us with. We are indeed grateful to have food on our plates, whereas there are so many who go hungry every single day. Nowadays, with the new apps like Zomato, Swiggy, and all of these available on our fingertips, where we can just press a button and order food and have so many different varieties, it's become so easy to have food. But nothing beats the home-cooked food cherished with our family members, because there is a secret ingredient. Can you guess what it is? Yes, the secret ingredient is love. So let's get started and watch our top cooks perform their magic. We now have our first category, which is main course. It was indeed wonderful to see participants prepare items like chicken biryani, khao sui, muttu roast, and all of these. Our parish does have talent, and I'm so grateful for all of you to take out the time and effort to prepare all these hearty meals for us. So let's watch.
Okay, everyone, so let's get started. We start off with the main course, and here you will see the magic of the parishioners of Salvation Church, right from small children to adults to seniors. So we start off with Leon Samuel showing us the muttu roast recipe. Muttu meaning egg in Mangalorean style. We then have Reese D'Souza dressed so well in her apron and showing us the chicken kafriyal. Oh, wow. That is indeed a challenge, Reese. Next, we have our budding master chef, Kester Pereira, presenting to us the jeera rice and chicken handi. Next up is Teresa Fernandez. Now, these are a seasoned cooks. So she's making the chicken malai sheikh biryani. Oh wow, Teresa, I definitely want to try this out. We then go to the land of Burma with Dagmar Fernandez presenting the chicken khao sui. Oh, isn't that lovely with the coconut milk gravy? Yummy. So, what is a feast without the classic chicken dum biryani? Yes, guys, cheer up for Anita Pace showing us the chicken dum biryani with the flavors and the colors. Next up, we have Sangeeta Valladares giving us the tandoori chicken. OMG, I'm drooling. And Sangeeta, I'm sure the shawarma guy, you know the shawarma guy we all go to? And these tandoori guys, they're definitely going to have a run for their money. Oh, we also have Claudia John D'Souza giving us a chicken fried rice. Again, the standard street food. Wow.
I'm Leon Fajul, and I also signed up for the cooking competition. I am from St. Anthony's St. Anthony's community, community number 2, and from St. Matthew's zone. From St. Matthew's zone. So we have 6 eggs, these are the ingredients, 6 eggs, 4 tomatoes, 6 onions. So we'll start by boiling the eggs.
Hi, this is Reese D'Souza and I will be preparing chicken kafriyal, and these are the ingredients. Half a kg of chicken applied with salt and ginger garlic paste and kept for 10 minutes. 5 big potatoes and sliced and applied with salt and turmeric powder. 5 big onions and finely chopped. 1 bunch of coriander. 8 pods of garlic, 1 ball of tamarind, 5 slices of ginger and 5 green chilies, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 5 sticks of cinnamon, 8 black pepper, 5 cloves, 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, and 3 cardamom, and now add a little water required. So now we have to grind all these ingredients in the mixer. water. Now we have to grind it in the mixer. Now I am going to saute the onions. First, we will put oil and then put all the onions. So the gas is on and I'm going to saute it on a low flame. Now I'm deep frying the potatoes. These are the deep fried potatoes. Now these are the onions which are fried, and now I'm going to add the chicken. And now I'm going to stir it for 1-2 minutes. Now I have the chicken is sauteed with the onions, and now I'm going to add the green masala paste. Now I'm going to mix it well, and then I'm going to keep it to cook for 15 to 20 minutes. Now I have added a little salt, and we are going to wait for it to cook. The chicken kafriyal is ready, and now I'm going to transfer it into a serving bowl. So now I'm going to place the potatoes, the fried potatoes, on the chicken kafriyal. Now the chicken kafriyal is ready. Thank you.
Chia rice and chicken handi. So just to, I'll start with the chicken handi first. We have to marinate it. So the first process. Let's take this chicken here. And then cut this into cubes. So I'm in the process of marinating the chicken. So what I did was I put the tandoori chicken masala. In case you don't have this, red chili powder is totally fine. So I put 1 tablespoon of this tandoori chicken masala and 2 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste. So now I'm going to marinate this and I'm going to eat. So basically, half a cup of rice equals 1 cup of water. So that is for the jeera rice.
Jeera rice, the main ingredient is missing. Yep, you guessed it right. Jeera, of course.
And to the rice, we'll obviously need salt. So 1 teaspoon of salt.
We have a full cup of water because half cup of rice. Put it in here.
Little like this. About tablespoons of ghee goes here.
I can go about it like this. So just keep stuff ready. Getting cooked and almost done. I'm gonna add the freshly chopped coriander leaves. This will be as a garnish, but also I'm adding it now. So it will add also flavors to the rice as it cooks. And we're gonna to ensure everything gets cooked. Just add 3 tablespoons. Tomatoes is the right time to add it now. It will add some water to it. teaspoon of syrup. Turmeric, chili powder. So this, whatever you put double. So example, if you put one of this, put two of this. So just keeping it. Right, this time our jeera rice is ready too. Yes. And now we can close this from our end while we concentrate on the second half of the dish. I'm going to empty it. Dahi and milk in the next one. Now with this, you can work as 3 or 4 tablespoons. Once I've made this quite some time, so the best way is by your hand, just crush. Now, even though we added this in kasturi methi, the color is almost the same, and it will be because the secret is over here. And three. Right now, the jeera rice, the chicken hundi is cooked. A salad. So a very good way to present the distinct onions is to make it via a onion chain. All you do it, take out one. Okay, and with a knife, just make a small cut. So it works like that. So now, as we see this opening, I'm going to put this over here. I'm going to decorate it with some kotmi. I'm going to plate it. And with that, voila, we are done. Signing off, Hester Pereira. Thank you all for your time. I hope I inspired you to cook or to try to cook. And thank you all.
Evening, dear parishioners. I am Claudia John D'Souza from St. Matthew's Zone, community number 21, and I am going to make chicken fried rice.
For making chicken fried rice, we are going to use eggs, fried chicken, chopped ginger, chopped garlic, chopped ginger, onions, carrots, capsicum, salt, black pepper powder, soya sauce, oil, and spring onions. I've used 3 eggs. I've put salt in the eggs. I'm going to stir these eggs with the fork. Now I'm going to put 2 pinches of black pepper powder and stir it together. Now I've put the frying pan on the gas. Now the frying pan is hot and I'm going to put half spoon oil. Now the oil is hot and I'm going to put the eggs. Now I'm going to scramble the eggs. Now the scrambled egg is ready. I'm going to remove it in a plate. I've removed the scrambled egg in a plate. Now I'm going to make the fried rice. Now I'm going to put 3 spoons of oil. I've put 3 spoons of oil. Now the oil is hot and I'm going to put garlic. And now I'm going to put ginger. Now I'm mixing the ginger and garlic and waiting till it becomes brown. Now I'm putting the onions. And mixing it. I'll fry it till it becomes golden brown. Now I'm going to put the carrots. Capsicum. And for 2 minutes I'm going to fry all together. Add salt in it. Now I'm going to add black pepper powder. Now I'm going to mix both together. Now I'm going to add rice in it. Now I have added rice and I'm going to mix all together. Now the vegetables are mixed and I'm going to add the soya sauce. And now I'm going to mix all together. Now I'm going to add the fried chickens. And now the scrambled eggs. And now I'm going to mix all together. Now for garnishing, I'm going to use spring onions. And now I'm mixing it. Now my fried rice is ready and I'm going to dish out. My chicken fried rice is ready. This is soya sauce. This is hot sauce. And these are some spring onions just for garnishing. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi everybody, I am Sangeeta Valadaris, community number 20, St. John the Baptist, Loop Zone. I am going to show you today how to prepare tandoori chicken, homemade tandoori chicken. So here are the ingredients.
So we have the leg pieces here. We have turmeric powder. There is a mix of garam masala and chili powder, Kashmiri red chili powder. There's black pepper powder. Also have some aromat, that is seasoning, salt, hunkered, ginger garlic paste, oil.
Participating and sharing your meals with us in the main course category. We are sure each of us are going to try it out and experiment for the feast day and during this time. Thank you so much. We now have our second category, which is desserts. And here we had a lot of our children also participating and sharing their desserts with us. So let's get started.
So once our tummies are full with all the biryanis and the fried rice and the chicken and all of that, let's now go to something sweet. So here are the entries for the dessert category. We start with our little angel Jemima Braganza showing us the banana bites. Easy peasy. We then have Janita Fernandez with a beautiful smile explaining to us how to make pancakes. Followed by Glynis Fernandez. Wow, I must say Glynis, those chocolate cream donuts were a real effort. I mean, making the dough, keeping it again, doing all of that procedure. I loved your effort. We also have Thea Alfonso showing us coconut ice. Simple and yet so yummy with, of course, coconut in it. Thea, I think you should get this for us for our feast day. Seriously. Okay. Now coming to our other young budding master chefs. There's Joyce Joseph adding a twist to the regular red velvet cupcake and giving us a red velvet tart instead. Wow, let's see it. We then have Jaden Machado showing us the cheesecake brownie, another twist to the regular plain brownies. Why not have the best of both worlds, right? Cheesecake and brownie together. And he does it with such finesse. I must say, Jaden, great job. We also have Susanna Fernandez showing us the vanilla cupcakes with an ocean theme. Did you guys guess that? She's put in those lovely mermaids and, you know, done all of that sprinklers and sparklers. Wow, I just feel transported somewhere else. Now, again coming to our seasoned chefs. We have Rochelle Fernandez giving us the Oreo dessert box. You see, our seasoned chefs, in the click of a finger, can just prepare any dessert for you. And any dessert with Oreo, you can't say no to. Oh, Michelle Alfonso shows us how to make the instant malai cake. I never thought rusk would be such an interesting item. But thank you, Michelle. You now show me a different way to enjoy rusk. We then have Magdalene Mendes transporting us to the land of France with the lemon souffle. Have you guys heard of the souffle or even tried it? Now you can. And she shows us how simply and so beautifully you can make any dessert that you love. You don't need to go anywhere. You just have everything right at your kitchen. Okay, we also have Jia Toshi with some festive cookies. That's an interesting take on the normal cookie. And bringing us back to our Indian Desi sweets is Manita Fernandez with the Gulab Jamun. Who doesn't love Gulab Jamun served at weddings?
Hi my friends, my name is Jemima. I'm going to make banana bites. I'm using a banana, milk cream, fruity fruity, chocolate syrup, M&M's. Take a banana, peel the banana, that spread on it. Take a spoonful. Then after that, put it over here. Put it in the chocolate. Put it upside down. Then after that, take this cream.
Hello everyone, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make pancakes. So the ingredients needed are 1 cup of wheat flour, 1 tablespoon of melted butter, 1 cup of milk, 1 tablespoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence, and a pinch of salt. So first you're going to put your wheat flour in your bowl. Next, you're gonna add in milk bit by bit. Then, you're gonna add in your sugar. You're gonna add in baking soda next. Then you're gonna add in a pinch of salt. Then you also have to add in the butter and mix until you get a smooth batter. So now you've got to heat a pan and you're gonna add in your batter. You can make it as big as and as small as you want. I'm just gonna make it medium. Now you've got to, the batter has to to bubble up until you can flip it to the other side. Looks like it's bubbled up. Now we've got to flip it. Wow, that looks really yummy already. So I've kept it for a little time. Now let's put it in the plate and let's make more. Well, our pancakes are ready. Now to garnish it, you need Nutella or maple syrup or honey. So you've got to take your Nutella and you've got to put it on one side of your pancake and you've got to spread it all over. So I've put the Nutella on one side. Now we've got to put the other piece of pancake on the other side. Wow, that looks really yummy. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Joyce Joseph and today I'm going to show you how to make red velvet tarts.
Take a bowl and in that put 80 grams of room temperature butter, 1 cup of all-purpose flour and 2 to 3 tablespoons of powdered sugar and combine it together. After combining it, put a few drops of red food coloring and knead it into a dough. After kneading the dough, let the dough cool in the fridge for about 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, take your dough out of the refrigerator and divide it into small equal portions according to the size of your mold and roll them. Take two small sheets of butter paper and place your dough ball in it and roll it into a thin sheet. Now dust some flour into your mold and place the thin sheet in it and cut the excess dough off. If you don't have a tart mold, you can use a cupcake mold or a steel bowl or even paper teacups. After that, poke some holes in your tart mold with the help of a fork.
So for that, here I've taken 1/2 liter of full fat cow milk. I've boiled the milk on high flame and to that I've added 1 tablespoon of vinegar. You can also use lemon juice and stirred it and shut the flame off and shut it with a lid and leave it undisturbed for about 1/2 hour. Then carefully collect the cheese curds in a fine sieve or a cheesecloth and squeezed all the water out from the cheese. And then I washed it again with a cup of chilled water to remove all the sourness of the vinegar. And then take your collected cheese and place it in a mixer and to that add 2 tablespoons of fresh curd or cream and grind it to a smooth paste. Now take your cream cheese and to that add 2 tablespoons of sugar and mix it. Here, I had taken half cup of whipping cream and whipped it. And add the sweet cream cheese mixture and a few drops of vanilla essence. And mix it together. Now gently demold the tart shells from the mold. And pipe in the cream that we prepared earlier. And there we go. Our red velvet tarts are ready to be served and enjoyed.
Hope you like this recipe. And please do try this recipe at home. And happy feast to one and all. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Today we are going to make 3-layer cheesecake brownies. So here I have 125 gram powder sugar, 75 gram brown sugar, 250 gram dark chocolate, 250 gram melted butter, 3 eggs, 50 gram chocolate and 190 gram flour. So let's start. I am going to add my eggs into my sugar mixture. Once this is all mixed up, we will keep it aside. Now we will take our dark chocolate and add our butter. Now I am going to melt this. Now that my chocolate and butter has melted, I am going to add it to my egg and sugar mixture. Now we are going to mix it till everything is nice and smooth. This is one of the really crucial steps in making the brownies. When this is all mixed, I am going to add my cocoa powder and my flour mixture, little by little. Once you see that all the flour and cocoa powder have got incorporated with the mixture, we will add a pinch of salt and a teaspoon of vanilla extract. I am going to bake this in preheated oven for 180 degrees Celsius for about 30 minutes. So now we are going to make our second layer, which is the cheesecake. So here I have 300 gram cream cheese, 250 gram mascarpone cheese, 1 egg, 3 tablespoons of milk, 75 grams sugar and a teaspoon of vanilla extract. So first I'm going to add my mascarpone cheese to the sugar. Then I will add the cream cheese. Now that everything looks combined, I am going to add the egg. Thank you. Now that my cheesecake layer is ready, I am going to make the ganache, which is made from 80 grams heavy cream and 240 grams chocolate.
صافن بكي في جنبي خليكي دنيا بتعطيكي وقتي نسيكي دموع هاليومين خلو عينيكي تعبانة حطي راسك عالمخدة جوا قلبي ما في قدك لونه أبيض هو قلبك ما حدا زيك يما شو عجبني ردك أنا دايما حضني جنبك لو كانوا كلهم ضدك حضل احبك حضل احبك برا 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 حضل احبك برا 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 هي قصة حب والقلب عم هي فيلم رومانسي شايف فيه أحلامنا ولو شو ما يصير بيناتنا ايدي بيدك هاي حياتنا دموع هاليومين خلو عينيك تعبانة حطي راسك عالمخدة جوا قلبي ما في قدك لونه أبيض هو قلبك ما حدا زيك يما شو عجبني ردك أنا دايما حضني جنبك لو كانوا كلهم ضدك حضل أحبك حضل أحبك لبيت كبير من الماس والله حبك ما بينقاس شو ما يقولوا الناس انتي دايما الاساس لبيت كبير من الماس والله حبك ما بينقاس شو بحبك اه بحبك اه بحبك حطي راسك على المخدة جوا قلبي ما في قد
Rapa pa 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 pa
عم تحكي لي كل شي فيكي وانا هسا ونصافن بكي في جنبي خليكي دنيا بتعطيكي وقتي نسيكي دموع هاليومين خلو عينيكي تعبانة حطي راسك عالمخدة جوا قلبي ما في قدك لونه أبيض هو قلبك ما حدا زيك يما شو عجبني ردك أنا دايما حضني جنبك لو كانوا كلهم ضدك حضل أحبك حضل أحبك
sugar, 1/4 cup maida, 2 teaspoon lemon zest, 1/4 cup lemon peel, lemon juice, 1 tablespoon of butter, 2 egg yolks, 3 egg whites, 1 cup of milk and powdered sugar for garnishing. So let's get started. Tablespoon sugar, 4 the lemon zest, lemon juice, and the butter. whisk these ingredients together. These four ingredients are mixed together. Now I'll mix the two egg yolks. The milk. Combine this in this mixture. Next, keep this aside. Next, we take the egg whites. And with the electrical. Now it has become into soft peaks. So to this, add little sugar slowly. After combining the sugar in this egg whites and beaten well, add small quantities of this to this lemon mixture. Mix this together. Slowly add all the egg white mixture in the lemon mixture. Slowly add all the egg white mixture into this mixture and whisk it well. So that
Stop.
Now this is ready. I'm pouring it in a greased baking pan. I'm just putting in a drop of color to this.
Stop.
I have slightly mixed in the color and kept it in the baking tray, which will be transferred to the oven, which is preheated at 180 degrees Celsius. I am now adding boiling water in the tray till it reaches 1 inch. This will now bake for 40 minutes.
Not.
Now it's ready. It was kept in the oven for 40 minutes. Now I'm going to garnish it with powdered sugar, a little cut of pineapple and mint leaves.
mom making gulab jamun. Now my mom is making the dough by adding milk. This is the ball which my mother made to make the gulab jamun. This is the pan where the oil is there placed now, and my mom is going to put the, now she's putting the sugar in the hot water to mix it and to make the sugar syrup. Ready to eat.
Thank you for your participation, everyone, and for sharing such wonderful, tasty, and easy dessert recipes with us, which I'm very sure we will be trying out and celebrating with our families. I really wished I could taste all of these things shared, both the main course and desserts. However, because of the pandemic and our restrictions to home, it was not possible. But I'm sure all of you had enjoyed this experience, and definitely we will come back for more. See you all again tomorrow on day 6 of the Navina, with Mass at 7 p.m. and the family night event at 8 p.m. Thank you for your participation and fellowship. It was wonderful being part of this.